Welcome, welcome, welcome one and all. It's awards night in Aggieland. This evening, the BCAs are presented by CHI St. Joseph, the official healthcare provider of Texas A&M Athletics. Settle in, grab the bucket of popcorn, and enjoy. Let me introduce you to your host tonight, Texas A&M's Director of Athletics, Ross Buehr.
Howdy. I think I heard that response. Aggies, it's good to be with you tonight. Although it's in a different setting this year, the BCAs are becoming a great tradition with Texas A&M Athletics. I understand that all of us are longing for the day when we're back together and when we can see you, our student athletes, wearing the maroon and white, competing for our school again. But tonight, even though it's virtual, we are together. And this is a chance to celebrate you, your wonderful accomplishments, and how well you represent Texas A&M University. Since it is such a big night, it's also becoming tradition that everyone gets really dressed up for the occasion. The lights shine bright at the BCAs, and you all certainly rise to the occasion with the wardrobe.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. But my little trash, man it's so tough.
Alright yo, put the belly on the body, make a catch. See no watch, now she wanna give chuck. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod. Man a real life sugar gal, I might forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Maybe this a Moncler sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fat like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather. Go broke never, on my grind. She make it click like I'm Busta Rhymes. I got the juice, the sauce and all them things. I've mallowed twice a night with all my bling.
Not bad, not bad at all. Your host could not be outdressed tonight. Although I didn't have time to shave my socially distant beard, I did try to step up my game as well. We've got some great presenters lined up tonight to help hand out the hardware to our award winners. And why don't we start right now? For our first nominees and winner this evening, I'll turn it over to one of our legendary swimmers who won gold at the 2012 Summer Olympics, Bria Larson.
Howdy, Ags. My name is Bria Larson, and thank you for joining us tonight. It is my honor to be able to present the Bill Irwin Scholar Athlete of the Year Award. This award goes to a male and female athlete who do an exceptional job at balancing athletics with their academics while maintaining a minimum of a 3.25 grade point average. Your female nominees are Katie Conklin from Equestrian, Ashley Driscoll from Women's Track and Field and Cross Country, Camille Connor from volleyball, Rena Eldridge from women's swimming and diving, Aaliyah Jackson from women's basketball, Macy Kolb from women's soccer, and Tatiana Makarova from women's tennis. And your BCA award goes to Ashley Driscoll and Rena Eldridge. Congratulations, ladies. We are so proud of you, and we cannot wait to see your continued success once you move on past Texas A&M.
I'm just really thankful for Texas A&M and the way that it's provided opportunities to be the best that I can be athletically and academically. Like, not only is Texas A&M like a top tier university with great research opportunities, but also a place where you can athletically thrive as well. Like, just the resources that we've been given and the people that support us are really unmatched. I'm so thankful for my coaches. My coaches have been such great supports, like in athletics and academically. Like, I'm not sure if Coach McRaven was more excited for my research project that I was presenting or SCCs a couple of days later. I just really think that that's like a testament to how the coaches have worked on developing us as people and as athletes. And I'm just so thankful for my teammates. I love them so much. And having them to support me and encourage me through school and through running has just been wonderful. I'm so thankful for them. Thank you so much. I'm so honored. Thanks and giggum.
Howdy, everybody. It's such an honor to have been nominated as the Bill Irwin Scholar Athlete of the Year, especially knowing all of the talented and driven student athletes I'm surrounded by here at A&M. But, of course, I couldn't have accomplished much if it weren't for the help of my team and my teammates, who have always been the one to push me both in and out of the water. I'd like to thank the faculty here at Aggie Athletics, who have done everything in their power to make sure that we leave A&M the most successful and prepared individuals that we can be when we're done with our time here. I'd also like to thank my family, who have been the ones to stand by my side and encourage me all of my life. I wouldn't have made it this far if it weren't for y'all. So thanks to everybody, and gig 'em.
Off to a great start with co-winners from track and field and cross country and swimming and diving. That was awesome. Now for the guys, let's see the nominees for Male Scholar Athlete. To present this award, he's no stranger to the bright lights. Performing nightly for the Lake Show, Alex Caruso.
Howdy, Ags. Alex Caruso here. Hope everyone's night's going good. I'm excited to present the Male Bill Irwin Scholar of the Year Award. And the nominees are John Bishop, men's track and field and cross country, Luke McGee, men's basketball, Ben Walker, men's swimming and diving, Chris Weber, baseball, and Braden White, football. And the winner is John Bishop. Congratulations, John.
To win this award, you know, it'd be thrilling. I'd be very grateful. And there would just be a ton of people to thank. I would have to start. So I'd have to thank, you know, my friends for always being there for me. I'd have to thank my teammates for just helping me every day at practice and having a positive attitude. You know, my coaches, because they've stuck with me over this whole time, even through the difficult times. You know, I'd have to thank the athletic department. You know, they give so much to us. You know, nutrition center, Nye Academic Center, just all, they want to help us in all facets of our experience. And finally, I'd have to thank my mom, my dad, and my sister. I couldn't have done it without them, and they mean so much to me. So, thank you.
Congratulations, John, and thanks to Alex for helping us out this evening. You know, if we can get the NBA season to resume soon, we might be headed towards a finals matchup between the Lakers and the Milwaukee Bucks. That would put two Aggies on the biggest stage of the basketball world, as Alex would likely go up against our next presenter. Here is Chris Middleton.
Howdy, Ags. I'm Chris Middleton, and I hope that everyone's doing well tonight. I am here to present the Newcomer of the Year Award. This award recognizes a female and male student athlete who has made significant athletic contributions during his or her initial year at Texas A&M. The male nominees are, for men's basketball, Quinn Jackson; for men's track and field, Carlton Orange; from football, Damani Richardson; and from baseball, Chris Weber. And the winner is Damani Richardson. Congrats, Damani, and good luck to you and the rest of the student athletes in the future.
First of all, I would like to thank God for just giving me my athletic ability. Second of all, I would like to thank my family for molding me into the man I am today. They made me work for everything. They didn't hand me anything. They made sure I worked to go get it. Third of all, I like to just give thanks to the coaches that recruited me and the whole coaching staff and that have faith in me. This award means a lot to me just because it just shows that the university appreciates me. And I, of course, appreciate them. It also shows that all my hard work and dedication is being recognized. Thank you.
Congrats, Damani. We're all looking forward to seeing you in those new Aggie uniforms that everyone has been talking about. Now, before we continue, I've realized since I've gotten here that we're all a pretty fun bunch. Let's see who has some of the best moves.
They don't fight you where I'm from. Like the beat, I keep a drum. You ain't got dough, little boy, you a bum. She got me that so dumb. Used to be broke, I ain't had no funds.
I spin it just for fun. Eat at Harold's just for lunch.
Walk up in a with the VVS. Can't get my ground cause I don't do the text. Don't give a damn about how you flex. Pull up with Cubans all over my neck. Check on blam, don't care who next.
Now those were pretty good, but I don't know if they were better than some of our coaches. I don't know. Maybe we call that a tie. Actually, coaches, stick to your day jobs. Now for the ladies. We'll have to wait to see the Tokyo Olympics until next summer. But when they begin, this Aggie will proudly take part in the opening ceremonies as a member of Mexico's softball team. She's our next presenter, Tori Vidalis.
Howdy, Aggieland. Tori Vidalis here, class of 18 and softball alum. Thank you so much for joining us for the first and hopefully the last virtual BCAs. Tonight, the Female Newcomer of the Year nominees are Deborah Aqua, track and field, Alyssa Claremont, swimming and diving, and Lauren Davis, volleyball. And the BCA goes to Deborah Aqua, track and field. Congratulations, Deborah. This is a huge accomplishment, and we hope to see you in maroon and white for a couple more years.
I thank the organization so much for the nomination. I feel honored to be recognized and nominated for the Newcomer of the Year Award. I would like to recognize Coach Brady, Coach Heston, Coach Hunter, and my teammate, particularly who has been an enduring inspiration to me. I sincerely thank everyone for helping me reach a stage where I can proudly hold this award as a mark of my achievement. I also promise to get better so that you can see me here for more such an award. I feel great working with such coaches, like the best coaches, where everyone is heard and cared for. I hope I will maintain the same level of dedication in the forthcoming years. Thank you.
Congratulations to Deborah and thanks to Tori. Good luck in next summer's Olympics. You know, selfless service is one of the most important core values here at A&M. And you, our student athletes, are taking it to heart. You participated in over 100 service events that totaled more than 3,000 hours. Over 400 of you were involved in at least one service project. And Aggie's Can this year provided over 50,000 meals for the Brazos Valley. The way you help the community is one of the many reasons we are so proud of you. So with that, let's give out the Selfless Service Award. Here to do so is Maggie Malone.
Howdy, Aggieland. Maggie Malone here, and I just want to thank you guys for letting me be at the BCAs this year. Tonight, I am presenting the Selfless Service Award. This award is presented to the student athlete who participates in the highest number of service hours for the academic year. This year's recipient has truly exemplified our core value of selfless service by completing almost 100 hours and attending over 20 different service opportunities. I'm so proud to announce that this year's winner of the Selfless Service Award goes to women's track and field student athlete, Brittany Parker. Way to represent our program, Brittany.
Wow, I'm really honored to receive this award. Selfless service is something that's super important to me and something I've dedicated a lot of my time to this semester, especially being the vice president of selfless service on SAC. I really felt like we made a lot of progress in that core value within our athletics department this year, so it's just made me really happy to not only serve others, but to see others, other athletes, so happy to serve others as well. With that being said, I want to give a special shout out to Nisha. She has been super helpful to me throughout this entire year, working with me all the time, doing selfless service stuff for SAC. Thank you, Nisha. Literally could not have done any of it without you. You're awesome. But thank you again for this award. I'm incredibly grateful.
Congrats, Brittany. As we near the halfway point of the show, let's take a look at highlights from 2019-20.
football. Aggie's running the other way. He lost the football, racing all the way into the end zone. Aggie's touchdown.
They say, move for me, move for me, move for me.
Savion, lob, Josh, jam. Kellen, over the middle, back in the end zone. Courtney Davis, touchdown.
On the run with another delivery, and she does it again.
Lauren Davis, and they've done it. The Aggies advance to the Sweet 16.
I lose control. When I lose control.
It's a 2-on-3 break. Shot goes up, blocked from behind.
Should I really even start? I got that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my across the street living large. Thinking back to the fact that they dead, thought my raps wasn't flexed.
Jones to Aggie Wells, and Wells puts it up and in off the right baseline. Got a 15-footer.
Twins, I could set it apart. I got big packs
Texas
coming
A&M
on the way.
Pitching strikes out 22.
I got Lil Max with me, he the wave. It's a big gap between us and the game. In the next life, I'm trying to stay paid.
Hope you're enjoying the evening thus far, Aggies. Again, we want to thank our presenting sponsor of the 2020 BCAs. CHI St. Joseph Health is the official healthcare provider of Texas A&M Athletics. We have more awards to give out. On with the show.
The Lohman Inspiration Award is always one of the highlights of the BCAs. We recognize one male and one female student athlete who have overcome obstacles to wear the maroon and white uniform. To introduce you to this evening's first Lohman Inspiration Award winner, here is an Aggie who represented her country, Jamaica, in 4 Olympic Games, Alia Atkinson.
Howdy, Aggs. My name is Alia Atkinson from the Texas A&M Fighting Class of 2010. I hope you all are having an amazing evening and keeping safe. The Lohman Inspiration Award recognizes student athletes at Texas A&M who have demonstrated integrity, and most importantly, perseverance in overcoming incredible challenges in pursuit of his or her education. They are role models for others who have faced adversity in their own lives and thought about giving up. Our first recipient of the Lohman Inspiration Award is Rian Murphy from Equestrian. Congratulations, Rian.
Several talk tough, but can they saddle up when the pain is excruciating? That's what she did for the Aggie Equestrian team, fighting back extreme discomfort from hip problems. Never complaining, she rode on, deservedly earning the Aggie Heart Award as a sophomore. Hip replacement surgery was required after the season. She wowed doctors with her recovery and was back up riding to start her junior year, winning MVP honors in the opening meet. Rian Murphy.
To be nominated for this award is really such an honor, to know I'm someone that people can look up to. To be able to win this award is really such a special feeling, especially among so many other talented and inspirational individuals. I would really have to thank my athletic trainer, David, and my coach, Abby, for their unwavering faith in me and always making sure I was able to do what I love most, which is to represent this school. Giga.
Congratulations, Rian, on winning this truly special award. We have one more that will receive the Lohman Inspiration Award this evening. Here to reveal them is the only Texas A&M football player ever to be taken with the first overall pick in the NFL draft, Miles Garrett.
Howdy, Aggs. I'm Miles Garrett. I'm glad to be with you this evening, at least virtually. The Lohman Inspiration Award honors student athletes who truly show us the power of the Aggie spirit and the never quit mentality of our student athletes. Our next recipient is Michael Clemens from football.
Perseverance can inspire, but it also reveals. After the loss of his father, he pressed on at a young age, helping his mother raise his brother. Through it all, showing the kind of grit that would make his current head coach proud, he made his way to college and forged ahead into the SEC, playing for one of the top programs in the nation. Never losing that mentality of caring for others, he led his team in community service. And his determination allowed him to earn his degree from A&M, with 1 year of football eligibility remaining. His perseverance revealed his inspiring character, Michael Clemens.
Hello, my name is Michael Clemens. I play football for Texas A&M University. If First off, I would like to say thank you for everyone who considered me for this award, and thank you for everyone who voted for me to win. I appreciate it. Thank you to my coaches, my teammates, our whole staff, and everyone that's, I guess, helped get to this point. Thank you. Everyone be safe. Love. Thanks and giggle.
Well done, Michael. Congratulations to you. Here at A&M, the work never ends trying to produce champions on the field and in the classroom. The resources available through the Center for Student Athlete Services allows our Aggies to flourish academically and prepare themselves for meaningful careers after Texas A&M. So let's take a look at some of the major accomplishments by our student athletes this year.
The spring of 2019 and fall of 2019 were the best semesters in the history of Texas A&M athletics, producing the highest ever GPAs respectively. Over 650 student athletes made the AD's honor roll, 43 were on the Dean's honor roll, and 21 were distinguished students. 13 Aggie teams earned a collective GPA of 3.0 or higher. As far as individuals, several have achieved phenomenal heights. John Bishop was the SEC Indoor Track and Field Scholar Athlete of the Year. NCAA postgraduate scholarships were awarded to Ashley Driscoll of Women's Track and Field and Cross Country, Wendell Mitchell from Men's Basketball, Brittany Parker of Women's Track and Field, and Anne Elizabeth Tebow of Equestrian. Tebow was also bestowed the SEC's Brad Davis Community Service Award along with Jake Gibbons of Men's Swimming and Diving. And finally, the prestigious H. Boyd McWhorter Award was given to Raina Eldridge of Women's Swimming and Diving and to Ben Walker of Men's Swimming and Diving. Congratulations, Aggies, on a great year in the classroom and in the community.
Sticking with the theme of academic success, I'd like to recognize our Aggie team GPA winner for this year. It was a very close competition between three sports, but the highest GPA belongs to women's golf at 3.333. Congratulations, ladies. Let's keep up the good work. Now for some individual academic award winners. Here's our next presenter. She's one of the best to ever play softball here at A&M, and you might recognize her these days on the SEC Network. Please welcome Amanda Scarborough.
Howdy, Ags. I'm Amanda Scarborough, class of 2008. Hope everybody is doing well tonight, staying safe, and staying positive. I'm excited to be with you tonight to present the Nye Academic Center Award. This award honors a male and a female student athlete who has demonstrated consistent dedication to their academics by utilizing resources, improving their academic performance, always giving their best effort, and having the discipline needed to be successful in the classroom while upholding the Aggie core values of respect, excellence, leadership, loyalty, integrity, and selfless service. The male nominees are, from football, Keldrick Carper. From football again, Clifford Chapman. And from baseball, Jonathan Childress. And the BCA goes to, drumroll please, Clifford Chapman. Congratulations, Clifford. You make Aggies everywhere proud.
Howdy. It's an honor to accept this award. This award means a lot to me. This award means hard work and dedication. And a lot of hours put into the Nye Academic Center. I would like to thank everyone at Nye Academic Center for uplifting me every day. Day in and day out, the hard work that you guys put in to help us be successful as student athletes is amazing. We couldn't ask for nothing better. Thank you, stay safe, and giggle.
Excellent, Clifford. Congratulations. That's one Academic Center winner down and one to go. To present the other one, here's a national champion from our women's basketball program, Sydney Colson.
Howdy, Eggs. I'm Sydney Colson. Thanks for joining us tonight. The female nominees for the Nye Academic Center Award are Mackenzie Green, women's basketball, Jania Martin, women's track and field, Emma Stevenson, women's swimming and diving. And Madison Wanica, equestrian. And the winner is Mackenzie Green. Congratulations, Mackenzie. Keep excelling in the classroom.
Howdy, my name is Mackenzie Green, and I play for the women's basketball team. It would be such a great honor to win the Knight Academic Center Award because my first semester was a little rocky. Just because of the fact that I was trying to get acclimated to my new basketball schedule and the academics at the college level. So my first semester wasn't what I wanted it to be, but I knew I could redeem myself this semester. My grades improved tremendously, and it made me realize that my grades could be exceptional for years to come. Winning this award would be such a huge accomplishment because I believe I made so much progress in such a short amount of time. I would like to thank Ms. D for staying on top of me about my grades at all times and expecting nothing but the best from me. I wouldn't be able to receive this award without her. I would like to thank my parents for keeping me positive and level-headed even when things weren't going my way. And last but certainly not least, I want to thank the committee because it means so much to me that you guys believe that I deserve this award. Thank you so much. And remember to catch some Aggie Women's basketball games next year. Thanks and giggle.
So after putting the success in the Academic Center on display, let's highlight our competitors on the field. It's time to bring you the Athletes of the Year. I'm very excited about our two presenters for this award. For the ladies, I want to introduce you to one of the best on the track to ever wear the maroon and white. And she herself is a national champion, Jessica Beard.
Howdy, my name is Jessica Beard, and I am here to present the FEMA Athlete of the Year. The Athlete of the Year Award is presented to the top male and top female student athlete based on athletic excellence and team leadership. The nominees for Female Athlete of the Year are: from women's basketball, Kennedy Carter; from women's track and field, Jasmine Frey; from volleyball, Holland Hans; from women's basketball, India Jones; from women's swimming and diving, Jing Kwa; and from soccer, Allie Watt. And the BCA goes to Jasmine Frey and Holland Hunt. Congrats, ladies. You've had spectacular seasons.
Hi, my name is Jasmine Frey. Thank you so much, Texas A&M, for nominating me for Athlete of the Year. This honestly means so much for me. After coming off my NCAA win in the 800 and the win in the 4x4, my senior year and having those two be my last races ever, being nominated for this award just means so much for me. And then on top of that, me actually winning this award means literally everything to me. I just can't tell you how much I love my school and how much I appreciate all my friends, family, coaches especially, trainers, athletic trainers that just helped me day in and day out do everything that I needed to do, Texas A&M donors for just providing everything that they provide just so that athletes can get everything that they need. So it really does mean a lot to me to make my team proud and my school proud and my coaches proud by doing well at NCAAs. And so I'm so happy to be honored with this award, and I really appreciate it. So thank you.
To receive this award, I am blown away, and I'm so thankful for the opportunities and experiences that I've had at Texas A&M that have led up to this moment. And I'm thankful to the Lord for allowing me to play volleyball at Texas A&M and represent Him, and just having the most amazing coaches and teammates and family that have been so supportive and loving and that have got me to where I am today. So thank you so much for this award of Athlete of the Year, and thank you so much, Texas A&M, for the best 4 years of my life. Thanks and gig 'em.
Jasmine and Holland, both very deserving, and congratulations to each of you. Now for the guys. This next presenter has a new quarterback in town and on his team. I'm guessing he's pretty excited about Tom Brady and has already started thinking about putting on that Super Bowl ring. Here's one of the best wide receivers in A&M history, Mike Evans.
Howdy, Aggs. This is Mike Evans, former Texas A&M Aggie, current Tampa Bay Buccaneer. Hope everyone's having a great evening, and I hope y'all staying safe. Here are your nominees for Top Male Athlete of the Year. From swimming and diving, Shane Cassis. From track and field, Devin Dixon. From baseball, Asa Lacy. From football, Braden Mann. And from men's tennis, Val Bachereau. And the BCA goes to Shane Cassis. Congrats, Shane.
I mean, it's a great honor for me, as well as my teammate and my coaches, because this shows that not only is the athletic department recognizing what I'm doing, it's also the public. They're seeing what this swim team is capable of, as long as myself. And I'm really appreciative of it. And I'd like to thank the coaches for the effort and time that they put into crafting my skill and ability. And I'd like to thank my family and my grandparents for sacrificing so much time, money, and energy into me and giving me the ability to follow my dreams and swim for Texas A&M. I'd also like to thank my teammates for pushing me to my limits and motivating me to be the best athlete I can be.
Congratulations, Shane. Before we give away the final awards of the evening, I want to look back at all the fun that we had during the 2019-2020 seasons. Go together. Better than birds of a feather, you and me. We've now come to the final awards of the evening. To round it out, we'll give away the prestigious honor of being Distinguished Letterman to one male and one female. Presenting our female award is a pretty distinguished Aggie herself. Not too long ago, she received the honor of becoming one of Texas A&M's SEC legends, Andrea Williams.
Howdy, Aggs. I'm Andrea Williams, class of 97. We are so glad that you could be with us this evening, and we hope that you are doing well and staying safe. The Distinguished Letterman's Awards are given to individuals who display extraordinary talents in the areas of athletics, scholarship, leadership, and service, and is the highest honor presented to a male and female student athlete each year. These student athletes embody the Aggie spirit and are truly exceptional representatives of Texas A&M University on the field of play, in the classroom, and in the community. I am honored to announce the nominees for the Female Distinguished Letterman's Awards. From women's tennis, Riley McQuaid. From women's track and field, Brittany Parker. From women's swimming and diving, Sam Siebenaller. From volleyball, Haley Slocum. And from women's basketball, Jasmine Williams. And the BCA goes to Brittany Parker.
Involvement is the key to college life. She knew this well. An active member of the Student Athlete Advisory Committee, she created opportunities for her peers to serve through the SAC Service Ambassador Program. She herself completed over 1,000 community service hours this academic year. Always representing A&M well on the track, her education was always a priority off it. And physical therapy school is in her future. Truly distinguished, Brittany Parker.
Wow. To be honest, I really couldn't even believe that I got nominated for this award, but to even receive it is just mind-blowing, honestly. Thank you so much for deeming me worthy of this award. I just want to thank, honestly, my coaches on the track team. I really, truly wouldn't be the individual and the woman that I am today without them. Being on their team and being their athlete has been probably one of the greatest experiences of my life, and it's shaped my character beyond explanation. I can't even begin to explain how much it has shaped my character. I especially want to thank and shout out to my own personal event coach, Coach Milton. He has probably had more faith in me most of the times than I've had in myself. He's always looking for me to be the best person that I can be, not just the best athlete, but the best person. And I think, and not even he does that, but all of our coaches do that. And I think that's what makes our coaches and our program so special, is that they really invest in you as an individual, not just as their athlete. And it just makes us, honestly, all around better athlete. So thank you so much. And thank you for this award. I'm super grateful and honored.
And lastly, for the Male Distinguished Letterman Award, our final presenter is no stranger to the bright lights. I'll turn it over to this former track and field student athlete who's been with ESPN for almost 2 decades, Fernando Palomo.
Howdy, Ags. I'm Fernando Palomo, class of 95. I'm former Texas A&M track team member. They told me, Fernando, it's a special evening. Well, I came dressed for it. I'm extremely honored to be part of this wonderful and definitely memorable night. Here are the nominees for the Male Distinguished Letterman's Award. From baseball, Mason Corbett. From men's track and field, Bryce Dedman. From men's swimming and diving, Jake Gibbons. From men's basketball, Wendell Chuck Mitchell. And from football, Colton Prater. And the BCA goes to Jake Gibbons. Jake, congratulations.
When he was looking for a spot on the A&M swimming and diving roster, it was said his leadership would certainly show up later in his career. That's prophetic because he was a team captain his junior and senior year. His ability to lead goes beyond the pool. He was the chair of the SEC Student Athlete Advisory Committee and is a member of the NCAA's Division I Committee. He holds a 3.78 GPA studying in the Bush School of Government and Public Services. He was also awarded the SEC's Brad Davis Scholarship. His leadership sets him apart. Jake Gibbons.
I'm so incredibly humbled and honored to be awarded the Distinguished Letterman's Award. I believe that there are many truly impressive student athletes at A&M who are worthy of this honor, and I'm proud to represent the hard work and accomplishments of all of my fellow Aggies. I cannot thank my teammates, coaches, advisors, and mentors enough for pushing me to be my best. To all my fellow Aggie student athletes, you inspire me. It's been a real privilege to compete, learn, and lead with you all by my side. I love you guys, and I miss you. Giggle.
Congratulations to Brittany and Jake as our final award winners of the evening. Both are deserving Distinguished Letterman. And a true pro, Fernando, even though they see you around the globe covering soccer, it is true that you can wear shorts on the bottom and a tuxedo on top at ESPN. As I said when we started, I can't wait to see all of you back here on campus, in the classroom, and competing on the athletic fields here at Texas A&M. I hope tonight provided you some connection with your fellow student athletes. I know the BCAs have always been a special night for you, and it's given you a chance to share some of the great moments with your teammates and fellow athletes. Thanks to all the student athletes for how you represent our university both on and off the field. We couldn't be more proud of you. Stay safe, stay healthy, and until I see you again, Giga Maggies.
Thanks for being with us, Ags. Again, tonight's BCAs have been presented by CHI St. Joseph Health, the official healthcare provider of Texas A&M Athletics. Thank you, and gig 'em.